What's up, guys? I'm out here chilling, enjoying these very beautiful views. And, you know, as I'm out here, something occurred to me. I realized I have not shared with you guys how I got my first wholesale deal. I talk about it, but I have not given you the real backstory about my first wholesale deal, just how I got it. So today, you know, I'm gonna go ahead and sit down because it's going, you know, get a little into it. I'm gonna go ahead and sit down and really get into it with you guys. So listen, my first wholesale deal, how it all started, it was back in February of 2019. That's when I closed it, right? But it began back in 2018, back in March of 2018. And after 9 months, right, of trial and error to me getting my first wholesale deal, which was in January, is when I actually got the deal, right? So it was many lists from, you know, list on absentee owners, all the lists you can pay for, every list you can pay for, I bought the list and I skip traced it, right? But that isn't what is that? That's not what got me my first wholesale deal. My first wholesale deal came by way of a free county list. That's why I teach you guys, you do not need PropStream and all these things, because my first wholesale deal came from free data from the county. And that list was a demolition list, right? So check your county, see if you guys have the demolition list. I literally Googled, you know, Hamilton County demolition list, or Cincinnati demolition list. It's either through the city or through the county. So with that being said, guys, once I got the deal, there was a bunch of people on there, right? So there's a bunch of properties on there, and they give the person a public hearing. So this is what the demolition list is. They give them a public hearing date to fix whatever is wrong with the property, so they can go in and present their case. The owner can go in and present their case to the city, to the county, about, you know, what needs to be done. They'll tell the city or county that, hey, this is what I can do. So in my specific situation, my specific deal, what happened was the guy, he ended up, you know, having a vacant building maintenance license that was needed for the property. Now, the property had been vacant for a while. It was in UC, University of Cincinnati, which is a college, which is, you know, a great deal because it was like a duplex, but it needed a full rehab. So it needed a complete full rehab in order to bring it back to life. So while great deal, it needed a full rehab. So it's about, you know, what price he wanted it at. Now, this is where somebody like, you know, you and I come in, and we are helping these clients out. We're really helping these people, because he was in a situation where it was going to just go to the county, and the county, they were going to demolish the property. Now, if the property get demolished, the homeowner has to pay for all of the fees associated with the demolition. And that can be upwards of $20,000, north of $20,000, right? So that being said, somebody like me, you know, a solution provider, somebody like yourself, I came in, I saw all the people on the list, I got the call in, I called everybody on the list, and nobody answered, right? So nobody on the list answered, and, you know, I left all my voicemails. This is why I teach you guys to make sure you leave your voicemails with enthusiasm. So I left all of my voicemails, and, you know, he ended up calling me back. So as I'm working, actually, I was at JD Byrider, you know, car detailer, and I'm in there cleaning the cars, and it used to be very loud because there were people with, you know, the vacuum cleaners, right? So vacuum cleaners, drills, everything going on. I get a call back, you know, I would always run out the garage. So I ran out the back of the garage real quick. I answer the phone, you know, hello, this is D'Angelo. And his name was Muhammad. And I'll just tell you, his first name was Muhammad. So his first name is Muhammad, but I'll never forget this guy. So he was a cool dude. So he told me about the property. And, you know, he was like, you know, are you interested? I was like, yeah, you know, that's why we gave you a call. So he was like, okay, perfect. You know, would you like to come and see it first? And my, like I said, this was 9 months, after 9 months of trial and error. So my game was already tight. So from there, I got the property under contract without going to see the property. That's why I tell you guys, you know, you don't have to inspect the property to get the property under contract, right? So I got the property under contract. I sent the contract over. And this is the short story, right? Got the property under contract, sent it over. And this was on January 8th, 2019. Got the property under contract. So after me getting the property under contract, you know, everything was lovely. Ended up sending it out to a few different people. And, you know, from that point of view, I basically make a long story short with you guys. I got the property sold, by way of somebody in a Facebook group. And I did the usual, you know, Facebook group thing. But I tell you guys, don't post your deals in Facebook group. And I mean that, don't post your deals in Facebook groups. But, you know, my story was a little bit unorthodox on how I got it. And if you like the deep breakdown of just of that part specifically, go ahead and, you know, click that link in the bio, My Real Estate Journey Thus Far, Steps to Success, episode number 4. Now, me getting the property sold was cool, but now, just to take it back in a little bit, in the beginning, in the middle of that, as the property was in escrow before it closed, right? Because when you sell the property, it still has to close. So, you know, when you get it sold, you have to go ahead and send it out to your title company. They start title work on the property. They tell you what needs to be done with it, if there's anything that needs to be done with it as far as liens, taxes, and mortgages, right? So it came back that, you know, there was obviously a couple taxes that needed to be paid, but there was a vacant building maintenance license that needed to be done. Now, let me give you guys the numbers. So I got the property under contract initially, right, at 30K. I got the property sold at 64,000, right? So that was 34,000, right? Now, you like, you know, you said you made, you know, 4,000. I didn't say. So I made 4,000 on the first deal. That's because I got it sold with somebody. Now, this is a $34,000, you know, split right there, right? Now, that being said, guys, the vacant building maintenance license, it cost about 22 or 23,000, and then there were some back taxes that we took care of for them. So we came out with $8,000. Now, there was a discrepancy there. So, you know, somebody, you know, a couple people that I talked to, they said the end buyer is supposed to be the one that pays that vacant building maintenance license. Some people said it's the owner that's supposed to pay it. Now, for me, it was my first wholesale deal, so I was not going to make, you know, that 23,000, 24,000. I was not going to put that between me and getting my first wholesale deal. So the lesson for you guys right there is do what it takes to get the deal done, especially if it's your first deal. Now, mind you, my first deal, my split could have been like 16,000-17,000, but I decided to just pay for it. So, you know, I ended up meeting with the guy. He was from Columbus. He drove all the way down to Cincinnati. He was like, you know, bro, do you really think we should pay for this, man? Like, you know, we could be making like, you know, 17,000 each if we, you know, just forced either had a buyer pay for it or have, you know, the seller pay for it. The seller should have been the one paying for it. So I'm like, bro, like the seller realistically is not going to pay for it just because, you know, he was going to basically let the property be demolished and, you know, or try to do something else with it. So that's putting him in a messed up situation. And then on top of that, the buyer, you know, they really could have paid for it, but at the same time, they weren't, right? So they were pressed. The buyers was pointing the fingers back at the sellers. The seller was, I didn't even go to him with like asking him to pay for it because I knew that wasn't gonna happen, right? Now, that being said, we ended up getting it done though. So we got the deal closed. After we got the vacant building maintenance license stuff situated, once we got that cleared, we got the deal closed and I received a check for $4,000 and I quit my job at JD Byrider. And I went full time in real estate wholesaling, right? And you know, fast forward like 2.5-3 years later, I'm here telling you the story. Now, why did I even tell you the story? What made it significant today? What made it, you know, you had to hear the story today, right? Now, a lot of things, a lot of reasons is if you, you know, having no, a lot of things is going on with the brand right now. There's a lot of upgrades, improvements, a lot of things that I'm doing. But one thing that really has not changed is that I really started this whole journey just with the reason to be able to share with you guys a way of life that I, you know, really, it was attracted to me by way of watching, you know, The Breakfast Club as far as wholesaling real estate. So I wanted to show you guys something that I never grew up, you know, learning about, never grew up learning about, you know, real estate investing, real estate wholesaling, any of these things, techniques that I teach you guys. So I'm going to take it a step further. I'm going to share with you guys how to get your first wholesale deal within 10 days. And the way I'm going to do that is by sharing with you guys, you know, day by day steps on what it would take to get your first wholesale deal in 10 days. Now, I told you, it took me 9 months to get my first wholesale deal. So it took me 9 months to get my first wholesale deal. What makes me think that you guys can get it in 10 days? Well, that's because I learned a thing or two over the course of these last 2.5 years, and I plan on sharing with you guys a couple things that I learned. And I also believe that you'll be consistent. Even if it's consistency for 10 days, I feel like that will lead you to success. And this is all a feeling, but I feel like, you know, at the end of the day, our feeling is all we need. There isn't many words to describe feelings, and that's, you know, a good thing if you ask me. One thing that's for sure though, if you have your heart in each step, then you're definitely already a success on your journey. Now, what I would recommend for you guys is to go ahead and subscribe if you have not subscribed, and also to hit that notification bell to make sure you stay up to date, because like I said, over the next 10 days, you know what it is, you know what my upload schedule is, over the next 10 days, I'm going to walk you guys through how to get your first wholesale deal in 10 days, day one being tomorrow, day two after that, day three after that, and it's on the floor until day 10. I appreciate you guys watching, and as always, get to stepping.